once you have your screws right here, whoop, see y'all, it's falling.
Welcome back to my channel, Anadolls, and welcome to my channel if you are new. Welcome to the Anadoll gang. All right, and if you guys have not subscribed yet, what you waiting for? Go ahead and subscribe, because I promise you will not regret it. All right, so as y'all read by the lovely title, today I'm going to be telling you guys and showing you guys how I record with my iPhone and like a YouTube behind the scenes setup. So y'all gonna see how I set up, what I use, and how I push these videos out for y'all. Okay, so without further ado, we're gonna go ahead and hop right into the video. Okay, so now, starting YouTube or a beginner YouTuber, I know y'all probably think that you need all of the expensive things to start your YouTube channel, and let me be the first to tell you that you do not need it, because I thought that too. I was not gonna start a channel until I had a Canon camera or the most expensive ring light. I'm here to tell you that you do not need all of those expensive things just to start your YouTube off, because think about it this way. If you go and invest in all of these things for your YouTube channel and you start your channel and you don't even want to do it no more, now what you gonna do with the equipment? What you gonna do? That's just a waste of money, even though you can sell it, but I'm trying to make a point here, okay? It's a waste. So that's why I think you should get into the YouTube thing first and make sure that this is what you wanna do before you go out and invest in all of these expensive things for your video. Okay, so for you guys that did not know, I actually record off my iPhone. I have an XR, so whatever type of phone you got, use it. I'm telling you, use it. Okay, use it. Okay, so now let's jump into how I record using my phone. So I got a couple of tips down. So the first one is, like I just said, you need a phone, no need for a camera. Now if somebody give you a camera, or if you just really 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 deeply need and want a camera, then hey, I'm not stopping you from doing it, but I'm just telling you that you don't have to go out and get these expensive cameras for a beginner YouTuber, okay? But now if you want it, that's a totally different story. You don't need it. So tip number two, I set my phone up horizontally, and stay to the end because I will show you guys the setup, okay? But I set my phone up horizontally because YouTube, if you set up your phone regularly, like how you take pictures, your video is not gonna be very appealing, because you're gonna have two of the image or the video in the middle, and then it's gonna be black on the outside of it, and that's not very appealing. You want your whole video to fill out the whole screen, you know, not just your video in the middle and then black on the side of your video. So that's why you're supposed to record horizontally. Increase your brightness all the way up. Quality over quantity, okay? Quality means a lot. It really does. Quality means a lot. Now I'm about to tell you, I know y'all probably thinking, but your phone camera is not that good versus a camera. Okay, listen, that's why I say turn your brightness all the way up, okay? You have to do that in order for your quality to be clear and crisp and just look really presentable. You have to turn the brightness all the way up, max it out. Like you max your credit card out, don't do that, but max that brightness out, okay? Turn it all the way up because you want it to be as clear and as bright as possible. Make sure your phone lens are clean. So just, you know, before you start recording, clean in front of your phone lens, clean the back of it. Just make sure it's clean, because if it's not, it's going to be blurry and it's just going to look nasty. So just make sure your lens on your phone are clean all the time. Not just for YouTube, you should want to make sure your lens are clean anyway, because who want to walk around with dirty lens? That's not cute. Okay, that's not cute. Okay, so number five. Some of you are probably thinking, should I record off my front camera? Should I record off the back camera? How should I do it? So I know a lot of people who say they record off the back camera, but me personally, I record off my front camera because it's easy. Well, I'm not gonna say it's easier, but you know what? I might try to record off my back camera and see how the quality looks, but I'm pretty sure it's gonna be a lot clearer. But the reason why I record off my front camera is because I have to look in the camera and make sure that I look presentable before I start. If you record off your back camera, you won't be able to see that, okay? But I might start recording off my back camera and see if y'all notice. But the thing is with your front camera though, if you're gonna record off your front camera, you actually have to look in the camera. You can't look in the middle, because if you look in the middle like this, you're not gonna be looking at the people, okay? It's gonna look like, I can't explain it, but it's like you're gonna be looking away and I'm literally looking in the middle. So you have to look at the actual camera and to be, you know, like, you have to look at the actual camera for it to look like you're looking at us, you know? You can't look in the middle because you're gonna look a little cross-eyed, or you're just gonna look like you're looking everywhere else but the center. But you have to look at the actual camera. And I know that is super complicated for some people because you're so used to looking in the middle when you record instead of looking on the side. But that's why I say, if you wanna record off your front camera, you have to learn to look in the actual camera versus the middle of your phone. And the back camera, like I said, I haven't tried it, but I'm pretty sure it's kind of the same thing. But of course, the back camera, you're not going to be looking in the middle, you're going to be looking in the camera as well. So okay, so now this is the fun part. I'm about to show you guys how I set up, what it looks like, blah 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 blah, all of that good stuff. So now come on, because we're gonna get into it now. So come on y'all, everybody, let's go, let's get it. Come on, let's go. Stand up. We're about to go on a field trip. Stand up. I'm about to show you guys. Okay, I want to make sure everybody is here before I get started. So let's wait on the others. You know, everybody gotta be here. Okay, everybody has to be present before I start. So we're just gonna wait on the others to get here. I told them to get up. They didn't want to get up. So now we gotta wait on them. Okay, everybody's here. I'm about to show you guys behind the scenes. Can probably tell I sit on my sofa and I record my videos. Excuse the sofa, it's a little dirty and wrinkly, but you get the gist. Okay, so you want to make sure that your background is presentable. I have a picture up here. The flower coordinates with the pillows. Excuse the horn outside. So the flower coordinates with the pillows. So just make sure that your background is presentable. You just don't want your background to look nasty. You want people to click on your video and enjoy the background and enjoy what you're talking about inside of your video. So yes, this is what my background looks like. Now, okay, so let's get into the ring light. Now, like I was saying earlier, super affordable if you don't get expensive things. You literally can start a YouTube channel under $100. So my ring light, I want to say my ring light was about $25 to $30 off of Amazon. And it's about 2 years old, probably. 2 years old, and it's still working fine. So let's get into it. Now, this button right here is actually how you turn it off. Okay, excuse my nails because they need to be done so bad. And you turn it back on like this. And you can also adjust the brightness. You can make it brighter.
or you can dim it down. Okay, and this string right here, not string, but this cord or wire right here actually connects to this, and it's just a plug. Ooh, do not want to come out. Okay, so I'm just going to show you guys exactly what you have to do to operate your ring light. Okay, so first you plug. You have how many? I have two different plugs. So this is the first plug. You plug it in like so. And then the second part right here, you take this and you actually plug it into this. And once you plug it in, that blue light will come on. So now you're gonna take this last plug right here and you're just gonna plug it into this. And then after you've plugged all of your cords, then you will proceed to turn the ring light on. Okay. Now this thing right here is to just adjust it, make it tall. Well, not make it taller, but it kind of adjusts this part. So I don't wanna touch it because I stay messing things up, but it adjusts this part right here. So it's like the tighter you do it, the tighter the ring light will sit, and the looser you do it, the ring light will be super loose. So of course you want to make it as tight as possible. Now this tool right here is to place your cell phone or a camera on, and you will be using this side right here. This is also adjustable. So the bigger your phone is, the wider it'll open, and the smaller your phone is, the smaller it'll open. So that's what that looks like. And this is another tool on the side. I don't use this, so I'm not gonna touch it because I don't want to mess nothing up, so I'm not gonna touch it. Now the legs. Okay y'all, I'm actually missing a screw right here. Right here I'm missing screws. So that explains why my legs are wobbly like this, because, and why this part is down and not up, because I'm missing screws. Now, as you can see over here, these are up and in place because they have screws. Same on this side. So what I'm trying to say is your legs on your ring light, it doesn't supposed to be like this. You're supposed to be able to. So majority of the time when I have my ring light, I actually have to prop it up with something in order for the legs not to fall over. But they're standing today, okay? They're standing today. But usually it'll fall over, because once you place this at the top with the screws, hold on. Once you have your screws right here, whoop, see y'all, it's falling. But y'all get what I'm saying. It's not staying in place because it's not screw on. These two pieces right here aren't screw on the way they're supposed to be. So that's why my ring light is a little unbalanced. But I am going to purchase some more screws so my ring light can stand again. These pieces right here are the ring light covers, so it can make, show you, if you, well, basically what you do is, you remove these right here and you put these on instead, and it gives you like a different lighting. But honestly, I don't like using the orange cover because it makes my face look too orange, so I'd rather use the white ones. It just gives me a better quality to me. But hey, to each his own. But yeah, I don't really use these. Okay, so now let's move over here. I know y'all probably like, okay, it's a blank wall, what about it? So this is my second area where I like to record. You see my stool right here. I actually purchased this stool from it was Home Goods. So just search up Home Goods and it'll pop up different stores, or you can actually go to Marshall's or Ross or something like that. I want to say it was about, how much was this? Probably, I think it was like $40. not bad. Still under $100. So sometimes I record right here as well. I'll just place my ring light right in front of the stool and just record. So usually when I record in front of the wall, it's probably like a hair tutorial, a hair review, or I don't know. That's really it. That's the only time I'll record in front of the wall, if it's a hair video or a hair review or something like that. And sometimes I actually don't like the lighting that I get when I record in front of the wall. I don't know if it's because the window is right here, but I guess the lighting from the window would hit this area as well. So I'm not sure, but it's probably because the wall is white. The lighting is different. You know, the wall is white over here as well, but you still get like a different, you get a different lighting. I can't explain it, but you get a different lighting. I'll try to insert videos from where I recorded here versus when I recorded here. And I'll try to show you guys the difference between the lightings. But it's a different lighting. So I don't always record here, but sometimes I do. Okay, so unfortunately this concludes my video. I showed you guys how I record behind the scenes, and I also informed you guys on information on how I record with my iPhone. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give me a thumbs up and click that notification bell so you won't miss any time I post a video. And thank you guys so much for watching. See y'all in my next video. Yeah.